Today, I'm going to be teaching you everything you need to know about cryptocurrency. Let's get started. You may have come to this video to find out what a cryptocurrency is, and put simply, cryptocurrency is a currency that is 100% digital. This means that there isn't any real item that you can hold, so no coin or banknote. Who created cryptocurrency? The original creator is currently unknown, but the alias the creator goes by is Satoshi Nakamoto. We do not know if this is a single person or a group of people, but we do know that they likely do not live in Japan, as stated, due to the fact that they have perfect English skills and occasionally use British slang. It is also believed that the creator lives in a country that speaks English as a native language, due to the fact that the Bitcoin software and documentation are not in Japanese. Satoshi Nakamoto created the biggest and first cryptocurrency called Bitcoin. Bitcoin is the most popular and most valuable cryptocurrency at the time I am writing the script, but it is possible that it will be overtaken by Ethereum, a coin that has been growing quickly recently and is currently the second largest cryptocurrency in terms of total market cap. Market cap is the total value of all coins combined at the current value of the coin, Ethereum being at $290 per coin. With all that aside, you may be asking yourself, how do these coins have value? Supply and demand. Wait. Before you click away, it is really like any other currency. If there is very little of that currency available, its value rises, and the same with opposite. If there is a lot of that currency available, its value lowers. Knowing that, you may be wondering, well, if the value of the coin is based on the amount of the coin that is available, how do people get coins in the first place? It may sound crazy, but you mine it. When I say mine, I don't mean start digging a hole in the ground. You're basically telling your computer or mining hardware, known as ASICs, more on that later, to calculate a number. Whoever gets that number right first gets the jackpot of the lottery. In Bitcoin's case, that is 25 Bitcoins. But wait, why are these computers calculating the number in the first place? Well, the computers are processing all the transactions, meaning that the computers are doing the same thing that a bank would do with a credit or debit card, which is telling the network to send over a certain amount of money to another person. Now you may be asking, well, if you can use a computer, why not just use that? Well, the thing is, at one point, people did only use computers. They started out using a CPU, which was good enough at the time, but then people figured out that graphics cards were much faster than CPUs, so everyone was forced to switch to graphics cards. After graphics cards came a thing called an ASIC. What is an ASIC, you may ask? Well, ASIC stands for Application Specific Integrated Circuit. The application in this case is cryptocurrency mining. These chips are designed to do one thing and one thing only. In Bitcoin's case, that is running an algorithm called SHA-256. These ASICs vary in size, coming in sizes as small as a USB thumb drive, all the way up to big boxes the size of a small computer. Since these ASICs are so fast, they generate a lot of heat, some being able to heat up an entire room in a few minutes, while others, like USB ASICs, only generate enough heat to burn you if you touch them. To give you a little perspective of how much faster ASICs are than graphics cards, the first ASIC was 20 times faster than the fastest graphics cards on the market at the time. A mid-range graphics card nowadays will run at about 600 to 700 megahertz. Compared to an ASIC miner, at about the same price, you will be able to mine at about 200 gigahertz. For those of you who don't know, 1 gigahertz is 1,000 megahertz, and 1 gigahertz is 1 billion calculations per cycle. That's pretty much it for this video. Comment below and tell me what your favorite cryptocurrency is. Mine is Dogecoin. I'll be reading all of your comments personally.